I'ma show you how to get it. It go right foot up, left foot slide, left foot up, right foot slide. Basically, I'm saying either way, we bout to slide. Hey, can't let this one slide. Hey, don't you wanna dance with me?
Welcome back to a new, what do I even need to call these? This is like a makeup look tutorial, I suppose. You guys have enjoyed the last few, so I am really enjoying putting these together for you. I'm getting ready today, and I'm going to do something a little bit different, not so natural as I have been, a bit more of a fuller base, and some new products that I've got, and also some kind of a lot of goodies that you already know of. And I'm going to do more of a bronzy goldy lid, whereas I've been doing a very neutral lid recently. I'm going to do something a little bit more exciting for you. So I've just finished off my hair with the Dyson Corral. It's literally just run out of battery, so I'll get that back on charge. I literally just have that always on my desk because it not only looks beautiful, but I use it so often. And now Alex apparently uses it too, because I found him in here the other day straightening his hair. I'm going to try this out today. This is brand new for me, the Chantecaille Flower Harmonising Cream. Just sounds really quite fancy, so I thought I'd try this on with you. Oh yeah, very, very light rose fragrance. Tell why though. Actually, first I'm going to use the 111 Skin Rose Gold Radiance Booster first, just because I want something kind of beneath the moisturiser. Add that first, because this feels really lovely, like a serum booster. And that's just a little touch of glow, which is really lovely. There's no colour to it, it's just quite a nice sort of, I always say it's quite a tacky base, which I love because it grabs the product. Let's try some of this. Ooh, it's really lovely and lightweight, so it moves nicely. This, for the first time too, this is like a brand new, like trying new products together. This is the Chantecaille Ultra Sun Protection SPF 45. I'm gonna see what this is like. I just got a little package today from Chantecaille. It's a bit, it's very like, it comes out almost like liquidy, but then it sinks in super quick. Okay, it's almost sinking into my hands faster than I can get it on my face. Okay, for base today, I'm going to use the Urban Decay Stay Naked Foundation. This is in 30CP. I have used this before, actually. I think I used this on the first set of stories that I did. So it's quite a light, it's definitely a light to medium foundation. If you apply it quite lightly, you can get a really skin-like effect to the skin. So it just, you can still see your skin beneath, which is why I like this one so much. It isn't all that heavy, but you can build it up as well and get a little bit more coverage if you want to, but it just adds a really lovely colour. It just adds a great colour to the skin and enhances the complexion. I'm just finishing up blending that into my skin just with an easy sponge, just so that there's no brush strokes and it's all kind of perfectly blended. By the way guys, if you do want to treat yourself to some Urban Decay products, they have a code right now on the site that's 25% off the whole site. And it's a code with me, and it's FRO25, all in caps. So use FRO25 on the site and you can get 25% off everything, which is amazing. So if you're someone who has loads of Urban Decay products in your routine and you need to top up again, or if you want to try something new that I might show you today, such as like the skin, the Naked Skin. Then on top of that, if you spend over £35, if you put in the code MINIS as well as FRO25, you can get a little set of Urban Decay's most loved eye minis. So you can get that as like a little special gift as well with the word minis. So FRO25 and minis if you spend over £35. So I thought that was pretty amazing. I'm just going to put on a little bit of balm because my lips just look a little bit thinny, and I love this one, this Le Paradis one. Okay, this is a day of really trying things. I'm going to try out the Shiseido Concealer now. This is the Synchro Skin Self-Refreshing Concealer in 201 Light. I can barely read that, my eyes are horrendous. Okay, let's have a go. I like this cute little brush it's got. Let's add that into my usual areas. And the same sponge, just to... Well, with that base and then that brightening concealer, that is one flawless base. I'm really happy with that. That is so nice. So moved a bit closer towards me. Okay, I'm going to go in with some powder. This is the Urban Decay Naked The Fix in 30 CP. Again, I think I mentioned this in one of my other stories, but it's, again, it's this really lovely lightweight powder. And in this shade, it just kind of works well for my skin tone, just to add a very light amount of colour and coverage. But it's been a while since I used a massive palette. This is the Naked, the Urban Decay Naked Honey Palette, and all of the colours are very honey, bronzy, golden tones. I've got a really kind of yellow. So I'm going to start off with Sweet, this one here, which is a really light kind of beigey tone. Just to start off in the crease of my eye. Okay, I'm still using Sweet. I'm just going to go a little bit higher over my crease, up towards my brow, but not touching it. Just a little bit more, just because I have hooded lids. So if I don't take it a bit higher, you're not going to see that colour there. So I'm just taking a little bit higher. Nice easy base down. Then I'm going to use Keeper. This kind of very tanned, honey, like caramelly shade. And I'm just going to start working out into the very outer portion of the eye here. This is a little bit more of a more precise, smaller brush as well. How beautiful is that colour? It's almost got like this mustardy caramel tone to it. So I'm just working it a little bit over the very top of the crease and then to this outer corner. Almost following a little bit of where I put that first shade, but making this a bit more precise in this area. Because I'm going to build up a couple of different shades overall. I'll take a little bit of that underneath actually because it's such a pretty colour. Okay, we're getting even more precise now. And I'm going to go into Drip, this third to the end. And this again is going to be even more precise and even smaller brush. Working it into the lash line. And almost to create a bit of a V shape here. So I'm not taking it all the way over, I'm just going to create like a shadow. I'm just going to almost flick this out to start forming the start of an eyeshadow flick. I don't often use eyeliner, I always use eyeshadow. Okay, so that is what I have so far. Now this would be like the perfect eye look for most days. It's a little bit smoky, it's got a couple of different layers, it's got a lovely gradient to it, but I want to be even more super duper fancy pantsy because I haven't been in a while. And I'm going to do a bit of a cut crease and I want to show you the way I do it because I know I didn't attempt it for ages because I was like, that just looks too difficult. When actually it's not that hard to do if you can afford the right products. And all I think you really need is your concealer and a flat brush, and that's all you really, really need for this. So I'm just going to take a little bit of concealer onto my flat brush, and all you need to do is map out, so where the crease of your eye is, that's just there, I just map out. The idea being that it just takes your eye back down to just like your skin tone colour. So then when you go to apply a product over that, you're able to get the product to stay and be super vibrant. That's literally the only point of it. So I'm just going to add, do the same to this eye. So just from the very inner corner, because I want to brighten that up. I don't know when that stopped filming, or if it was filming. Okay, I'm now applying Honey, which is this, the lightest gold in the palette. And I have been applying, when I wasn't filming, to the very inner corner here. And just a tiny bit into the start of the eyelid over that concealer. And we're going to start building it up the same way that we did with the darker shades. Just making my brush a little bit damp with the Urban Decay All Nighter Setting Spray. Oops. And I'm going to go in with the next shade up, which is Golden. It's a teeny, teeny bit more gold. And I'm going to use this flat brush. Flat brush is super important because it's then easier to push the product into the edges of that concealer to keep that line quite. Okay, so I've just gone back into the palette with Keeper and Drip again, and I'm just going to really closely apply that to the outer corner, and it'll just help blend all of that into the outer portion of the eye. Okay, So all I've done is just kind of gone a little bit more over the eyeliner sections to intensify it again. And I've blended, and that's my look. Well, my eye look, I know, not lining. A little bit filling the lips with Victoria Beckham lip liner in 01. It's a really light. My lashes a tiny touch. This is the Laura Mercier. Okay, I'm gonna try out, not try this yet, the new Chantecaille, might not even be new, the Chantecaille Faux Cils Mascara. This is quite a natural, fluttery eyelash look. Okay, I've got to say, I am absolutely in love with this eye makeup. It is so pretty, and it's so nice to make a little bit more effort with my eye makeup than usual. I'm just going to go in with the Lumine Watercolour Bronzer, which, as you probably know, is one of my absolute favourites when it comes to adding some warmth. I love my creamy products. Then I'm going to use this, which I just received from By Terry. This is the Brightening CC palette in Sunny Flash. This looks beautiful. I'm going to use the pinky tones. A little bit of my cheeks. And I'm going to go in with the sort of lighter highlighter shade and just add that touch of light up here. It's really subtle. Okay, brows. I've just added my usual Laura Mercier pencil, and I'm just going to use some of the Urban Decay Brow Endowed, and I'm just going to use this primer on this end because I really like the way it looks, especially for me as a blonde. It gives this like white tinge to the brows. If you brush it through properly, obviously, and don't leave little bits of white, it almost makes them look a little bit bleached, whilst also it really brushes them out. I think that just looks really, really nice. And obviously, if you've got dark hair, this colour just isn't quite right for me. It's really quite dark, but it's so precise. If you had dark hair, and last but not least, a touch of gloss over top. This is the High Shine from Urban Decay in Back Talk. And whilst I like my lips now, it's going to add a tiny touch of this. Yeah, thanks for watching, guys. I hope you're having a good day, and I'll see you soon.